Schreck.
And James.
Myth, legends, and lies. Where we're at today. The place where the most legendary Hollywood cowboy met his end.
That's true.
Right down the road at that bridge.
Just at the bridge there.
Wow. It almost feels eerie out here, doesn't it?
Oh, it does.
I mean, if you don't know Tom Mix, you're talking about the biggest cowboy star ever. Fair to say?
The original, too.
Wow. And today, I'm on a lonesome stretch of highway between Tucson, Arizona, and Phoenix, Arizona, old Highway 80. Now, if you'd have been here on October 12th, 1940, there'd been two things. It'd have been a dirt road, and there wouldn't have been a bridge up here because it just got washed out by a flash flood. Now, Tom Mix was hurtling down this highway that was dirt over 100 miles an hour in a supercharged Cord. And he failed to see those workers. And what happened was, is he couldn't get it shut down. So when he finally did see them and hit the brakes, it was too late. And then what happened was that car rolled over into the ditch, and a metal suitcase that was in the back seat came and hit him in the back of the head and broke his neck. Now, the legend is that that suitcase had cash, it's over $6,000, traveler's checks, and priceless jewels that were in that car at the time of his death. Now, we're at this location because there is a monument, and I'm here with James. And James, what do you think about this place?
I think this is a place you have to come see. If you are a fan of Western culture, Western film, Arizona history, this is kind of a must-do.
Now, he was the original cowboy, right?
He was.
I mean, he was the original. I mean, he... Now, they said he made $7,500 a week.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to go a week in the early 1900s.
In the very early 1900s, during the days of silent film.
I mean, that is incredible, mm-hmm. Right? It's incredible that... Now, even in later in the 20s, I was also told that he made $20,000 to $30,000 mm-hmm. a week.
Yep, during the Depression, when your average family was making like $100 a year, he was pulling in $30,000 a week.
That is incredible. Now, he was 60 years old when he met his demise at this location,
mm-hmm.
where they say on the sign where his spirit left his body. And, you know, man, the guy lived large, didn't he?
Oh, he did. He had quite the life. I mean, he had a ranch up in Prescott. He had the Cord. I mean, he had everything, you know, and he lived it up. You know, the reason he was on this road on that day was because he had just been filming in Las Vegas, New Mexico. He stopped in Tucson to visit the sheriff, that was a friend of his. They had a night of partying down at the gambling house. He was up until 3 a.m. hanging out with the musicians of the area, and then slept till noon, got up, and about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, he was driving right by this location.
Wow. And you know what? I mean, you know, people don't realize how big he was, though. I mean, he wasn't just a movie star to a certain degree, too. I mean, he was Wyatt Earp's, the famous Wyatt Earp's, one of his pallbearers, right?
He was.
It's just to show you how he blended in from that generation of the real cowboy. And then he was a cowboy, but he took it to the next level, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, he was an absolute legend.
That is unbelievable. And, you know, it's kind of a weird place down here. It's like everything in Arizona. It feels really, it's cool, but it feels kind of mysterious, right?
It does.
I don't want to say creepy, but it feels really mysterious that, you know, that one of the most famous people at that time left this earth at this location. They say this location, but it was on down. I have pictures of that, too.
Just down the road here.
Yeah, and wow.
Nope. It's now the Highway 79, but it is the original Highway 80.
Right, okay.
So, you know, you definitely, if you're planning to make this trip, just know you're looking for the 79.
Well, you know, they're not going to see a lot, but it is it's kind of hallowed ground if you're into Old West. I mean, if you're into Old West stuff, you definitely have to make a run here. And again, this is a, you know, he wasn't a native, but he definitely spent a lot of time, just like the next legendary cowboy, I would probably say, you know, there were Woody Rogers and some of those guys, and there might be different levels, but, you know, he was on the same level as John Wayne, in my opinion.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
At that era.
Yeah, I mean, without him, there wouldn't be a John Wayne, because
right.
he, I mean, he was working with those directors at the beginning of the film era.
You know, we're not far from a place called Florence, Coolidge, mm-hmm. and Casa Grande, right?
I was just going to say, if you're making this trip, you can make a day out of it.
And there's also the Casa Grande ruins that are down here also. And James has got a... He's got a...
Get the action shot.
He's getting ready to be stung to death. Well, maybe not to death, because I could probably get him to the hospital. But it's going to be good. J.Schreck.
And James.
On the trail of Tom Mix. We found him. J.Schreck and James on the trail of Tom Mix.